There's a woman who has been accused and tried of killing a police officer. However, she's not guilty of murder at all. Let's put up the picture for Mass and let me give you the background. You are about to hear a hell of a story. In Phoenix, Miss Nubia Rodriguez on the left, who multiple judges found was wrongly charged, multiple judges said this, with negligent homicide for the traffic death of Officer Paul Rutherford on the right. Now, it is a tragedy that Officer Rutherford died. That's a tragedy. This woman, Miss Nubia Rodriguez, is now set to sue the city of Phoenix for malicious prosecution. She filed an official notice of claim on March 15th, a week ahead of the four-year anniversary of the accident. The notice of claim is filed only against Phoenix and not the Maricopa County Attorney's Office. Let me say this. The reason why this notice is required is because before you sue a governmental entity, you have to give notice of suit. Okay, so this is a mandated performance dynamic that has to happen. It's an administrative issue. If you do not do this, your suit can be kicked out summarily by the court. So let me give you background on what happened. It was March 21st, 2019. Miss Rodriguez hit Officer Rutherford. That is not in debate. She hit him in the two-way turn lane on Indian School Road near 75th Avenue. The officer, who was not wearing a safety vest, was working a traffic accident when he suddenly ran into traffic without looking. He did not look both ways, ran into traffic, and accident happened, right? Body camera video shows Ms. Rodriguez was hysterical at the scene, screaming, "Why did he do that? Why did he do that?" It's been a heartbreaking situation from day one. She told ABC 15 during an interview, "I mourn and cry for this man that lost his life, even though I never met him." You know why she cries and mourns for him? Because she has a soul. She has a soul. She has a heart. There's a human being dead because she ran into them. She feels bad about that. Now, as it relates to the law, to statute, she never should have been charged with any crime because she committed none. Let me give you the background. For a year and a half, Ms. Rodriguez said she didn't hear anything from police after that incident. Then, all of a sudden, a letter came in the mail that informed her a grand jury has indicted her with negligent homicide, a permeation of murder. "It looked like junk mail," she said. "I just essentially lost it." She also was a therapeutic foster mom. And Rodriguez said the criminal charges against her caused her what? To lose custody of a 9-year-old special needs child in her care, who she was in the process of adopting, the foster child. Was taken away on her birthday. Let me give you some issues with this prosecutor. The lawsuit claims there were multiple false statements that Phoenix Detective Michael Davidson told the grand jury. Now remember, grand jury proceedings are secretive, all right? They're secretive. So Michael Davidson, the detective, goes into this secret grand jury proceeding, lies to the grand jury when securing the indictment. Now, who else knows he's lying? Likely the prosecutor, okay? So 1-2 combination in that grand jury room. The claim also emphasizes that the Phoenix police and the county's attorney's office did not show the grand jury business security video that captured the officer suddenly darting into traffic. That is a big deal. It's part of the case, part of the why he was hit in the first place. The video is really the reason I was able to back the claim of what actually took place. It took 2 years for the criminal case to fully unravel. Detective Gregory Gibbs, let's go to Gibbs, said under cross-examination that there was internal anger directed at him because he included a critical line in his final report that stated Rutherford shared blame in the crash because he failed to look both ways. That specific fact was intentionally not presented by the police or the prosecutors to the grand jury. Now remember, multiple judges have already ruled she was charged wrongly. All right, there's more. In the summer of 2022, Maricopa County Superior Court Judge Jennifer Ryan Tuhill ruled that the police and the prosecutors initially presented grand jury members with evidence and testimony that was misleading and designed to distract from the true facts of the case. The case was then sent to a new judge for a preliminary hearing to decide whether charges should have ever been brought. After a three-day hearing, another judge, Judge Joseph Creamer, tossed the case out for good. So what happened? What really went down? Unfortunate accident. That's what it was. Unfortunate accident. The officer committed an unfortunate mistake. Ran out into traffic, did not look, was probably excited and anxious about trying to help the traffic situation at hand. None of that is criminal. It is unfortunate, yes, but not criminal. She hits the person who ran out into the street. That's not criminal. There's no negligence on her side. There's no gross negligence. There's no, she was breaking the law, speeding. None of that happened. He ran out in front of her. And instead of the county doing the right thing, because this was a police officer, they decide to do the wrong thing. That is not justice for this cop. That is not justice for that community. That is injustice. You want to put an innocent woman in jail because of the death of a police officer, an unfortunate death that is not a crime. That's not honoring his name. That doesn't honor his legacy. All that does is honor the corruption that we talk about on a regular basis, spewing out of police agencies and their allies. Now, at some point, this us and them dynamic that exists between cop and community will have to settle. But when you have actions like this from prosecutors, police officers willing to lie, false information being presented, cops who put the right thing on the police report being blacklisted, that's a cultural dynamic. Everybody decided to not follow the law. That's not a policy issue. That's a culture issue. All right. Dear brother, thoughts?
Yeah, you know, when you make a false statement to a grand jury and it destroys somebody's life, yeah. And sometimes not telling all the facts is just like a lie. People like that should be looked into, investigated, and probably disbarred. So a lot of people sit behind bars and spending the rest of their lives in jail because of things that the prosecutor did, politically motivated, and just didn't have the right motive or whatever. It was a freak accident, like you said. And it need to be accounted. How do you get a charge wrong? You know, and all the different judges that the case went in front of threw it out, Dr. Richey. But, you know, if you do something like that, falsely charge somebody or wrongly charge somebody or keep certain facts away from the grand jury, and it destroyed that lady's life, the lady lost her kids and everything or whatever. So where's the accountability? You know, you should sue the city of Phoenix, anybody that had anything to do with that, messing up her life, should be held accountable. Yep. And that attorney should be disbarred.
Yeah. And it is criminal. It's criminal to lie under oath. It's criminal to fabricate evidence. It's criminal to fudge an investigation. It's called felony obstruction, violation of oath of office. The judges said what they did was criminal without using the word criminal. The least that should happen is disbarment for this kind of behavior. That's the least that should take place.